Yeah, this is Oscar from Blue Pride Kennels, a proud member of the Elite Age. I've been in the bully game for about 15 years. What got me started is just pretty much, man, the love of the dogs. I've had them just about all my life, was raised with them. And well, right now, the style of dog that I'm breeding is pretty much bully, you know what I mean? The bulliest, the better for me. Try to keep it semi-correct, you know? Yeah, my foundation male has been Chief. I mean, we took his daughters and bred them to Easy Rider, and that's what he, you know, that's what gave us the style of dog that everybody's loving out there right now, you know? To me, Bully is a dog that is just impressive, man. It's got everything, you know what I mean? The showstopper, that's what a bully is to me. The bloodlines that I mainly deal with is razor's edge, man, but I'm not afraid to mess with anything else, man. I pretty much deal with every single blood, you know? It really doesn't matter to me, you know? I can make it work with any blood. You know what, Lolo, he's probably my smallest, my shortest bully right now. Mainly razor's edge, you know what I mean, with some Norwood in there. He's probably about 45 to 50 pounds, you know, about 14 inches tall. Got a real nice defined head, you know, something that I really like about him. But he's becoming to be one of my best producers. I mean, he got tons of kids out there, man, that are just killing it, you know? I mean, pretty soon I'll have my website up and people will be able to see what I've produced, you know? Especially what he has done. And by the way, Tommy's his son, you know? Tommy Guns, he's probably about 85 to 90 pounds. You know, he's only a youngster. He's only about a year old. He just hit a year. And he got a lot more to go. So if people like him now, they're gonna love him in 6 months from now, you know what I mean? He hasn't hit maturity yet. Hustler's probably one of my favorite dogs in my yard. He's like my own personal dog. Hustler's probably about 90 pounds. He's about 18 inches tall. I mean, I love the guy. He's got a hell of an attitude, a lot of drive. It's really what I like in a dog, you know what I mean? But I was willing to please, you know? I mean, the guy could hit the pole. He could chase balls. I mean, name it, he'll do it, you know what I mean? I will be using him a lot more in the future, kind of like just for me. You know, he's got a lot of good productions out there. If people look into it, you'll be able to see, man. But the guy is just, you know, he's really what I look for in a dog. And this is my main producer, Easy Rider. He's probably about 85 pounds. I mean, honestly, a lot of people consider him to be one of the best producers of all time. And it's not just me saying it. You know, if you do the research, man, you'll see all his kids. A lot of his kids are being used now as Kennel's main studs, you know what I mean? Some of his main studs, it's Playboy from Long Beach, LB Finest. You got Easy Does It from Vicious Kennels. You got Bazooka from Next Round. You got Mission from Legion of Doom. You got Fonzie from Zen Styles. You got my boy Lolo. And you got Curly from Packing Heat Kennels. Banzas, I mean, there's just tons of them, man. If you, you know, do the research, another big name out there is Omen. We got Omen, we got Trunks. I mean, just too many to name right now, you know, but, and I couldn't be happier with him, man. I mean, he's done a whole lot for me and the dog game. So that's it, man. You guys see my yard, see my dogs. Thanks for stopping by and checking us out. Just want to send out a special shout out to all my EE family. You know what I mean? Much love to all you.
My name is Lisa, and this is Cooper, my dog. Cooper was at the shelter, the Burbank shelter. This wasn't planned. This was just Cooper came into my life type of thing. I got Cooper, and gradually, of course, my neighbors are going to meet him and my friends. And I didn't really think about having a pit bull type dog. I didn't think of a pit bull as any different than any other dog. Like if I'd adopted a lab or a golden retriever, I mean, he's a dog. I was more astonished that I had a dog in the house. But my friends were astonished that I had a pit bull. And I thought, why? Well, what's the difference? It's a dog. His joy is nonstop. His love is completely unconditional. So when I come home from work every day, It's not like one day's reaction is different from another day. He is always completely overjoyed to see me. And that's great to come home to. The problem is, and one of the reasons I think I ended up getting Cooper is that there are just too many dogs. There are just too many dogs on the street. There are too many dogs and not enough homes. He's certainly not a fighting dog. A lot of people see his ears and think that, but he doesn't have the personality for it. He doesn't have the aggression. So a responsible breeder would be sure that regardless of how the puppies come out, regardless of conformation, regardless of whether or not they meet exacting standards of show quality or for whatever reason they're being bred, that the breeder knows that they can place the dogs in good homes. He's a great dog, and all of those dogs deserve good homes. So my hope is that if people choose to breed, that they breed responsibly, that they don't inbreed, that they're concerned about the health of the animals, not just what they look like, and that they know that they can find good homes for these animals, even if they don't meet show quality standards. I'm Lisa, and I'm probably not the usual picture of a pit bull owner. I'm a pretty unlikely pit bull owner, but I'm a really happy pit bull owner. I'm really satisfied with the bully I got.
What's cracking, Bully Badass? This is T-Bone, Game Over Bullies, one of the founders of the 91 West Empire. I'm going to show you a little bit what we're working with on this side of town in Compton. Basically, we based our yard off of a lot of the Moomoo blood. You know, we like that bone, that girt, you know. We like that compact. We like tall dogs, short dogs, any kind of dogs, nice headpiece. We got them all over here at the 91 West. And, you know, starting off with one of my females that I like. Her name is Seduction. She's off of Prince Gotti, bred to his mama, Queen Lunatic. Prince Gotti's off of One Drop and Queen Lunatic, and Queen Lunatic's off of Goliath Moomoo. This is another dog that I'm trying to show you right here. His name is Stax. He's off of Boogie to Queen Lunatic. Boogie's off of Monster Lefty. Queen Lunatic's off of Goliath Moomoo. This is another dog that I want to show you guys. Her name is Baby Lunatic. She's one of the little shortest Golden Boy daughters out here right now. One of the most beautiful females that Golden Boy's produced. Her name is Baby Lunatic, and she's off of a Golden Boy bred back to his mom, Queen Lunatic. As you can see, I like a lot of that Queen Lunatic blood. You know, if it keeps spitting, if it's throwing, I say keep the model. So Golden Boy's off of Kingdom Queen Lunatic. And Queen Lunatic's off of Goliath Moomoo, which is Legend's Little Mate's sister, Queen Lunatic. Another male that I want to show you, his name is Capone. He's 100% out of Ed Shepherd's yard. He's off of Otto, bred to Kasia. He grandson off of Boogie. He's a nice male, nice, you know, nice head all around. One of the best Otto sons out there right now. This is another female that I want to show you guys. Her name is Golden Angel. She's off of Golden Boy. Golden Boy was bred to Blue Angel. Blue Angel's off of Goliath Moomoo, which is Legend's Little Mate's sister. And you know, Golden Boy is off of Kingdom to Queen Lunatic. This is one of the boys that I like right now, one of the upcoming studs that's gonna be hitting for the 2010. His name is Jigsaw. Picked him up from Houston, Texas. You know, shout out to Adrian. Thanks, Adrian, you know, letting me pick up this boy. He's off of Kryptonite. Kryptonite's Little Mate Brothers to Kingdom and Prince Spade. And bred to Nana. Nana's off of Pesado Gabbana, and Kryptonite's off of King Spade, Queen of Hearts. All right, well, thank you guys for coming out here, City of Compton. Visit the Game Over Camp, 91 West Empire. And, you know, thanks Bully Badass for coming down and visit us over here. And you see what we're working with over here on this side of town. We keep it consistent. That Moomoo blood, Gotti line all day. Shout out to Joe from 91 West. Shout out to Silos, Carlos, Notorious Kennels, and shout out to my boy Jimmy Cofal, Downtown Kennels.
This is Whiskey Chuck, almost 2 years old. He come for Pacino and Triple X daughter. I get it when he have like 3 months old. I buy to my buddy Jaime for Star Pits. Very friendly. I love my dog. And he's like 90 pounds, weigh like 90 pounds. Maybe like 18 inches tall. For information, go to JalicoKennels.com. My number is 310-415-0749. Thank you and see you guys.
These are some of the best dogs in the South Coast, West Coast, East Coast, wherever you want to go. We got some of the best dogs right here in Cali representing.
How you doing today? This is Damiano right here with Bully League. We're out here representing. We got a t-shirt company right here, Bully League. It started off as a t-shirt company. My background is more into the events, so we're combining a t-shirt company with the events. And lo and behold, working with Yukonuba, we saw the need to open up a pet food store called Bully League Pet Nutrition Center. And so we got it in Fontana, California. That's right, the address is 10557 Juniper Avenue. Come check us out. The first Bully League, the Bully dog pet food company of its kind for the Bully community. So come check us out. Also, we're dropping the Bully League Classifieds. That's right, it's gonna be a free magazine that's gonna go to everybody in the community, and it's gonna help the, basically a distribution system for people to get their studs known out there, you know, whether they got their kennel club, blow it up, whatever it is you want to do, we can help you distribute. That's the whole thing that Bully League is. We're a distribution powerhouse. So whether it's a t-shirt, whether it's an event, whether it's a magazine or pet food, Bully League is where it's at. That's right, we're a distribution powerhouse, and we're here for the bully scene.
Hi, my name is Luciano Aguilar, and I'm from Sit Mean Sit Los Angeles Dog Training. We specialize in basically building the focus in the dog, and then from there being able to do exactly what it is you want us to do. We can take your dog all the way from just plain simple obedience all the way on up to trick training and you know, customize it for you. So if you guys want a dog that is super well trained, listens to you and does everything out of love and respect, you know, please give us a call. We'll give you a free evaluation. Just mention this video, and we'll be more than happy to help you guys out. Our number is 310-538-1553, and you guys can actually visit us online and check out our many videos at www.sitmeansit.com. Again, I'm Luciano from Sit Mean Sit.
Good boy. Yeah, my boy. All right, this is Albert, Thing Bullies, Diego Kennels. Diego Kennels, my kennel name. Thing Bullies kind of brought together for Thing, you know, to represent everything. If you go to the site, it represents everything he's doing. currently working on Diego Kennels, which you'll see coming soon, which is all my dogs, Center, Thing, Nila, Cha-Cha, kind of what they've done all these years and offsprings, you know. The ultimate bully for me is King Kamali, Omen. Florida is where I actually, first time I've seen Omen, and I actually, a second time I've seen Rizzy, but really got to see him. And Omen right now, I think, is, like I said, as a dog, I definitely want to bring him to the program. He's just the overdone Thing, but people say he's a big dog, but he's still shorter than Thing, just a little more dog all around. And I'm just, you know, honest about it, and I was really impressed on how he looked that day, and his headpiece, and just everything, you know? So that's probably the dog that, leaving there, that I definitely will be using in my program. That's my main stud right there. He's directly off of Nila and Manu. Cassidy's Manu. Thing's about 18 and a quarter. Could wear anywhere from 87 to 92. 92's probably been the most he's weighed. Those are in his early days. 87's probably pretty average weight for him. He's got pretty close to about a 24-inch head. Never has he been known for the biggest head, but it's just the overall structure. And what he does, I mean, you guys all know he does throw. He does have the capabilities of throwing the 25 like King Kamali and stuff like that, you know. Just an amazing producer. Came into this bully game when it first started with that look people wanted, and he was used a lot, put a lot out there. And like I said, just a living legend right now. Sinner's my new male, probably one of my favorite dogs actually to own. I like his drive. And, you know, Sinner's about a 100-pound dog, 24 and a half inch head, you know, 18, maybe about 19 inches. You know, bigger dog, heavy Cairo, like I said, he's directly off of Nemesis, directly off of Nina. Nila's a direct Cairo daughter. Nemesis's parents are both off Cairo littermate, so bred real heavy with the Cairo actual blood. What I like about Sinner is when he actually gets stuff off of him, he throws heavy bone that I don't see off a Thing, you know, so I kind of think the combo of two later would work out really good. Sinner produced a Texas Legacy, a dog that they know out there in the Midwest, out there building toys, and we've actually, now this year, 2010, I'm starting to use them. I collaborated with Sammy over there with Heartbreaker, probably produced me one of the best looking little bully females that I've seen. Reddy is a new male that we got, kind of collaborated, you know, wanted to get something new. Like I said, my whole thing is I like the big dogs, but also, you know, want to bring bone, substance, and head size to a lot of these shorter dogs that I'll be using that are off the Thing. And Reddy's probably going to be a dog that you're going to see used heavily to direct Thing daughters. He's off of Melly, which is King Kamali's later mate sister, bred back to Cassidy's boy, Thriller Gorilla. And with him, as I went back, connected with Cassidy, and we're trying to bring a little more bone, head size, you know, so we can go back to these pockets and bring you some extreme bone, pockets with more bone, more head. So he's definitely a dog you'll see in our program. When we take him back to Thing Daughters, there'll be a two times Thing, but bringing the bone and head I want to see. Cha-Cha's an old school girl, direct short shot diamond. She's probably about 18 inches, 75, 80 pounds. She's a big girl, usually bigger than most males. Probably 22 and a half, something like that. But she's directly off short shot diamond. That's one of my first dogs that I started with. Her and Thing's mom built this, everything off of them too. She's pretty much retired now, she's done, but she still stays here at the camp. Thank you guys for coming out. You guys got a chance to see the legendary Thing and my personal favorite Sinner. I'll catch you guys at the San Diego shows.
Yo, what's up, y'all? It's your boy Ferocious Macadocious, representing Hood Kennels. And I'm here to show this big boy right here, G-Money. It's my boy YP Dog. G-Money coming in at 13 months old with a big 24-inch head. 50% Gotti line, 50% Royal, and he's coming off a bumper and a female Dooney. You can contact us if you want to get in touch with us to check on this big boy at Hood Kennels. The number, area code 877-471-5427, or you can hit my boy YP at MySpace/Hood Kennels.
How's it going? I'm Jason from Monsprit Kennels. The philosophy here at Monsprit Kennels, to make a beautiful dog, unique, exotic looks and colors on pit bulls. American bully dogs, I should call them, because we're slowly changing the breed. Exotically and structurally, I'm talking about an all-around bully dog. Neck just is extremely crazy. Chest to go with it, and bone that, you know, just sets itself apart from other dogs. I breed guiding line dogs. I started my old branch of dogs off the guiding line with my dog Don Julio. I've made some Don dogs, which I've been pushing out, which is also called Don line. Just a different style guiding line dog. Just to represent my stud, Don Julio, he's throwing a different style dog. Like I said, a really extreme bully, clean look. Don Julio, what he is, he's a different style dog, man. Since he was a baby, he was always a girthy little pup, and knew right away when I got him from North County Guiding Line's yard, he was gonna be something special. And as he's growing, he's growing with such a massive chest, massive features, you know, with his neck and his shoulders. And, you know, he's got a big size head, but his neck's so much more thicker that it takes away from the head. But, you know, all around, he's just an extreme exotic. When I mean exotic on the look too, as well as he's not the everyday type of brindle. He's more of a, I would say like a marble type of dog, you know? I've accomplished a lot with Don Julio so far, and he's a youngster. He's only 3 years old, but I've won best in shows, first ever ABKC Extreme Champ. Foundation female is a direct monster Moomoo daughter. Moomoo's the blood, as we all know, Ace and Blackjack 21 and so forth, sister. She's a foundation female, made some very nice dogs. Directly with Monster Moomoo, I would say is one of probably the most impressive breedings of a decade. And they've also produced some of the most unique dogs. For instance, One Drop, Conan She-Devil, you know, Mojo's sister, my female's Mojo, came out to be some of the most extreme and exotic looking pit bulls. As we all know, we all have Don Julio here at MPK, repping Don line to the fullest. You know what I mean? He's making some of the top-notch hitters out there, dog. Like, I got one, for example, Don King. Here we go. He's a freak, man. You guys just keep an eye out for this boy. He's coming out hard. Don King's off of our foundation bitch, Mojo. Mojo's a direct monster Moomoo female, so you can imagine that pedigree. We also brought out Moomoo. Moomoo's also a foundation female. She's off of our MPK's Mojo as well, Don Julio Mojo. And bred together, those make some of the most extreme puppies out to date. Don Grizzly is a little pup off of Don Julio and Sweet and Low. She's off of our female Mojo as well, our foundation female. She was bred to Don Julio and had this beautiful pup. His name is Grizzly, like I said, Don Grizzly. You guys keep that name going in your heads, because it's going to be ringing out there one day. Here we go with, I call her No Fair. The reason to be at No Fair, because she's just No Fair. When she walks, she waddles. Donna Black's, this little pup right here, is just going to be something crazy, you know. As far as Mini Mocha goes, right here, the little red nose, little female right here, she's actually not a red nose, she's a blue nose, but she came out with this one-of-a-kind color, you know what I mean, just to go with our exotic looks, you know what I mean? Had to bring her into the game. She's a little different. She's got a little personality. And of course, this blue one that we made right here, this is one of the ones we made for show. She was bred to a 21 Blackjack daughter to make something this clean. This is Donna Mama. Another one was Mini Mocha. Hey, thank you guys for stopping here at Monsprit Kennels. MPK, Guiding Lines MPK. So that's the website, www.guidinglinesmpk.com. You've been with us, you've seen us. If you guys know what we're doing, short, wide, thick, and bully, if you guys are down with it, you know what I mean? Check us out, hit us up. We do easy business, we do everything easy.
My name's Hyman from House of Blue Pit Bulls. I got my boy here out of Pokemon and Savage. He's 15 months old. As far as stud fees, contact me at 626-201-9699. He looks pretty good. We gotta check him out.
My name is Marco Suarez. I'm with Suarez Bulls Kennels. Paco is our foundation dog. When we got Paco, we never had the intention to become a kennel. This happens through the years, actually, when we start to show Paco in the ring. When he became a champion, it for us was, I can't even describe the feelings, you know. It wasn't like today. We didn't have the all the internet and all the magazines and all the you know, the way we communicate nowadays. Making Paco a champion was actually a super battle back then. Shows, they were not as often as, you know, they're made, you know, we make them today. They were one every 6 months, one every year. So those shows were like full of dogs, full of dogs. They were packed with dogs. Each category should, you know, used to be 35, 40, 45 dogs per category. So winning back then, to me, it was a big thing. I'm not saying that today there's no competition. Of course there's competition, and of course the breed continues to change, and you know, there's new looks, there's, you know, new stuff all the time. But it's more like it's easier to get to a show nowadays. You don't have to take a plane necessarily. The reason why I started to work with Resource Edge is the style of the dog. You know, there's many different type of bullies. They're all beautiful, of course. But is the Resource Edge, the style of these dogs are a little bit different. And actually within Resource Edge, I choose to work with the most compact, you know, dogs. So I actually chose specifically dogs with those traits. Dogs that will, you know, either males or females, that they're known for produce very compact dogs with the same style as, you know, known as a Resource Edge, you know, style. I also have my own liking, specific things that you know, that I like, and I start to breed towards that. And when the passion is there, it's a never-ending thing. You know, you always want it to get better. You think that better is this big head, this short bag, and this much bone. You get there, you're gonna want something else. You know, I guess it's something, you know, very human. We are in our fourth and fifth generation of doing so. And we've been lucky. We've been achieving what we've been dreaming with. Paco has the most incredible genes. The consistency with this dog is just amazing. So at this point, we got Bricks is the new dog that we bought, and I think this dog is going to bring what we need for our new plans. You know, we're trying to evolve into something new. We're very happy we have done with the Paco blood, and we would like to mix it with the Rock and Ruby blood now. These dogs are Resource Edge also. The Rock and Ruby, the strain of Resource Edge. And Bricks is a Rock and Ruby on the top, and Little Raw and Cookie Monster on the bottom. All this is Resource Edge. All these dogs are famous for do very specific things and for being very special. But we feel that combining that blood with, or that strain with what we work, I think it's gonna take us to that level we like to get. Just a little twist, a little change in the look, and and also maybe in the attitude, maybe we want a little bit of a little more of I don't know what to say, more orientated into the athlete. I think I'm choosing the right dog. You know, we did a lot of research before we got out of our kennel. Usually we don't work out of our kennel. We work with our staff only. And we're happy with what we're trying to do right now. We're happy with our plans, actually very excited. That should be the word. Very, very excited.
My name is Jonathan Edwards from Oceanside, California. I'm from Backyard Bully Camp. My whole philosophy behind this and the reason why I'm in the game is I want to create stuff that represents me. I'd like to set a standard and set a bar. Clean, correct bully dog. Yeah, thick bone, chest, head, short snout, big rear, and short back. I want my full-grown males to look like pups still. And my females to look almost the same caliber as males, but a little bit shorter and female-like. The first dog I'm gonna bring out is my male that I'm using right now to jump off my camp, and his name is King Sammy. King Sammy is a 13-month-old male. He's got a 24-inch head. He's about 85 pounds, good bone, perfect rear. The reason why I picked Sam as my number one is because, for one, he has the perfect temperament. He's just a relaxed dog, and he just wants to live and be a dog. And that's perfect for me. Okay, so you guys just seen my boy King Sam, and next thing I got for you is my foundation female. Her name is Miss Baby. She is a four times West Side Monster female. And she is my foundation female. Also, she's my first dog that got me into this bully game. She is currently about to be 2 years old. She's been bred twice to only razor edge dogs. I yet have to see what she can do with the Gotti line. She's got a 21-inch head. She's an 85-pound female. And great temperament, explosive rear. Rear's bigger than a lot of males that I've seen. And that's what she's known for, and that's what she's throwing. So I hope you guys see what I see in her. As Baby being my first female, I tend to keep her inside. She's also my son's dog, which is 6 years old. She sleeps in there. She sleeps with my son. She sleeps in the blankets. She's one of us. You guys just got done seeing Baby. Step into the yard and see a couple of her sons that I have here on the yard from her very first breeding. This is Doughboy. He's 10 months old. He's off Baby's first breeding to Hindu's twin brother Cochino. This is Goomba, also off of Baby's first litter. This is Doughboy's twin brother. He currently has a 21 and a half inch head. I think he weighs about 70. He's a little more compact, a little bit more shape than Doughboy. Better rear. And this is Goomba, his twin brother. As you can see, Baby, she throws consistent rear ends. She throws her rear end in everything. And this is a prime example of what she's done for me so far. And this is Jonathan Edwards signing out, Backyard Bully Camp. I hope you guys liked what I brought to you guys today. Thanks for seeing my beginning, and you guys will see more of me in the future. Love and peace.
Hey, what's up, man? Introducing my boy, Shanrock, to you guys, man. A year and a half, off of Tonka and Jada, off of Stud, man. Give me a call at area code 312-546-1002.
How you doing? This is Joe from Squire's Bullies.
This is Clive from Clive Brewery too.
Basically, the main dogs that we have here are, you know, extreme. You know, that's what we're known for. You know, most compact, more wider chest, you know, more shoulders than your normal bully. 2004 is basically when we started doing the extreme bully thing, you know. Started off with Bismarcky, you know, started getting a couple females, different bloodlines, you know, that consist Razor Edge, you know, the little bit of, you know, the Gray Line Gotti, you know. Basically, we studied the bloodlines to produce, you know, short, compact, no muzzle, short back.
An extreme look.
Yeah. Bismarcky, it's out of TI and Banji. You know, the main focus is just 100% Razor Edge. You know, if we throw a little mix and guiding line, we just produce extreme freaks, you know, these extreme bullies. A lot of people have seen what he's produced with Lalo daughters, you know, with basically Legend daughter. Yep. So it's just pups that you never seen before, you know, the look they never seen. You know, we just focus on the female. We also, you know, want to make sure the right females go to Bismarcky and the other males here, you know, to produce the extreme look. Basically, we also have his brother Humpty and his half-brother Booyah. You know, that's the top producing female right now, Banji. And she's produced other extreme dogs for us also. You know, rest in peace Bronco. People knew him for a little bit. And also we got, she also produced that litter with Bismarcky, Humpty, Dougie Fresh. That litter was just consistent and just, you know, full of extreme bullies right there. And then also she, you know, also produced our up-and-coming stud, Booyah, out of Pee Wee and Banji. He's also, you know, real extreme, something that people don't see all the time. So, you know, and we're glad to have these dogs out here in the West Coast. Everyone's just calling off the hook, you know. We got plenty of years to go. Bismarcky, you know, just barely turned two. His offspring's growing up. A lot of people are gonna be seeing a lot of him soon and years to come, so. He's going to be, you know, it's the start of a new legend right there. So, you know, anyone, you know, wants to get towards the extreme bully, you know where to go. Squire's Bullies right here. You know, we love, you know, the bully world. We love going to the shows. You're going to be seeing us a lot more now in shows. You know, we love the, you know, the people. They treat us well. We treat them well. And basically, you know, the Squire's Bully is here to stay. Anyone, you know, has any questions, you're welcome to call us anytime, you know. We're good people, man. We love, you know, talking about bullies all day, every day. So, you know, that's what we do. And basically, the future for, you know, Squire is just improving the extreme bully, improving the bully, you know, showing the positive, you know, of the bully, you know, for years to come.
This is Tapatio for Jalisco Kennels. Almost 3 years. I have a one thing. I get it when he had 1 year old. It's 2 times Georgia. He come for Estavi and Chiquita. So very friendly, you know, for my kids. It's my favorite dog. Information, go to JaliscoKennels.com. My number is 310-415-0749. So I'll see you guys, thank you.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? This is Dante at American Pitbull Kennels. I'm over here at one of our main facilities right here, as you can see in the back. Basically, what we do here is we produce some of the finest pit bulls that San Diego has to offer. I met my partner, Diego, which is the founder of American Pitbull Kennels. He basically introduced me into the breeding game. So we hit it off ever since then, and, you know, trying to get good business going. All right, so I'm gonna take you on a little tour of what we got going on in the kennel. Show you a couple of the finer ones we produced. And let me introduce you over here to Junior over here. He's one of our prized possessions, son of Monster. He's about 14 months, excuse me. 85% Razor's Edge, 15% Nevada. He's 85% Razor's Edge, 15% Gotti Line. And he's at 98 pounds at about 2.5 years, about to be 3. All right here we got Unam.
She's 100% Nemesis, roughly about 96 pounds right now, 2.5 years old.
With that said and done, let me get you over to the founder, Diego, and his son, Carlos.
Hello, everybody. My name is Carlos Garcia. This is my father, Diego Garcia, and we are from American Pit Bull Kennels. The bloodlines that we're using are Nevada, Gaudy Line, and Razor Edge. We first started off with a red-nosed pit bull, and then we moved on to a blue line. And from blue line, we're trying to move on to bullies. And basically, what we're trying to do bullies is because they're very lovable, they're kid-friendly, and they're not only our best friends, but they're also part of the family. We have 10 bullies in our kennel, but today I'm only gonna show you 4. Our first dog, Rush, he's actually my dog. I named him Rush because he's just like a shot of adrenaline rush. He's just crazy, he's active, he loves kids and everything. He's just out there. He's 85% Razor Edge and 15% Nevada. He really loves that treadmill. He just gets on, like as you've seen in the video, he just gets on and he does his thing. He likes to exercise, he loves that thing, and he could be there for hours. Our second dog, Chingon, he's 11 months, and he's also 85% Razor Edge and 15% Nevada, and he's a really sweet dog as well. He doesn't really like the treadmill, but he loves to run around and just do his thing. Our next dog is Chata, she's 2 years old. She's 50% Butterhead and 50% Gaudy Line as well. And she's actually, her father is Geronimo from Travis Pitts. Chata, she's, whenever we go to a community show or anything like that, she's a crowd favorite. She takes around 25 to 40 pictures, and she's a crowd pleaser. Our next dog is Shorty. She is 11 months and she's already 96 pounds. She is 50% Nemesis and 50% Gaudy Line. This is Carlos Garcia and Diego Garcia from American Pit Bull Kennels. Well, we hope that you had a great time, and thank you for stopping by at American Pit Bull Kennels, and hope to see you around the show.
I've been training these guys at my house on weekends, so you guys are welcome to come over the house. If you want your dog to wait for, where do you live? Riverside!
Welcome to El Granero El Gallo de Oro, located in 8228 South Central, Los Angeles, California. We have all types of supplies Everything from harnesses to collars to even dog shampoos. We're specializing in for the bully community, and we got all types of foods. Diamond, Yukonuba, Pro Pack, Sport Mix, for all the types of bullies. So high in protein, high in fat, basically to keep your bullies just right. We have harnesses for all types of dogs, but we like to specialize in bully. And our harnesses consist of from like small sizes to basically extra large sizes. We have all types of collars. Basically, you guys seen everything that we have to offer. We're a family-orientated run business. And I'm gonna introduce you guys to my father, Hector, and my uncle, Sergio. I also have a kennel, and I'm gonna take you guys and show you guys to my kennel. We'll show you what Guideline has to offer. Located right here in the heart of Watts. And I'm about to show you what Guideline has to offer, show you what I'm working with. This is right here, Big BMK's Big Mama. She's had a Bully Mob Kennels Princess and Wicked Coast Bullies Berserk. She's a Berserk daughter. She has that thickness, shortness, compactness. Bully Mob Kennels Negra. And she's also a Berserk daughter. She's had a Princess, Bully Mob Kennels Princess, and Wicked Coast Bullies Berserk. So Berserk daughter. To me, I think she's one of the best Berserk daughters, shortest Berserk daughter. She's a real freak. She's Precious, and she's had a Zeus, Boogie Osita, and a Marcelo daughter, which is a direct Gotti son. She's littermate to Chevy, which is what her other one's a sister. Gigi, she's had a Golden Boy in Fusca. Everybody knows Golden Boy. Literal bullies. Fusca, Trick Mamas, and Legend, that's Boogie and Gypsy. She got the thickness. There's a famous princess, Bully Mob Kennels Princess. She's out of Shorty in Italy. Gotti Bola, Goliath and Shine. It's real exclusive. My productions, she's out of Zeus and Marcelo daughter, which is a direct Gotti son. And right here, this is owned by my friend Hector. My kennel Zeus, he's out of Boogie Osita. Best bloodline ever, best pedigree, unmatchable. Nobody got this out there, and I'm lucky to own him. Super short snout, big dome. He's up. He's also up for stud. Stud, 1,000 up for stud.
It turned out to be a really great day. The weather was nice. It was supposed to rain this morning. We had a little overcast, but it's clear, kind of a little cloudy. Man, a great turnout, great people. A lot of different kennels, new people that have been doing it for a while. Man, it was a great turnout. Barbecues going, just a lot of, you know, a lot of nice dogs, good people. And if anybody's interested in shows or events and want to get into this, you can go to bullyshows.com. and find your local event, or if you're wanting to be a show host or get involved with the ABKC, you can go on bullyshows.com or even abkcdogs.org, you know, and check out the site and get involved, you know.
When you come around, just so, yeah, yeah. Hey. I'm so sick of-
don't say nothing about you sexing me, sexing me. All I want is for your body to be next to me. In a pair of boy shorts or a thong, it's your choice, long as you put me on. Have you like Tyson, might just bite my damn ear off. I wanna go 10 rounds, and I'm gonna tear it up, then I'm gonna beat it down.
What's up, everybody? This is Fabian, the CEO of Remy Line. Coming back at you one more time, I have a couple big congratulations I'd like to give out. First and foremost, I would like to thank E40 for being the first RLC champion. Congratulations, man, you're the first official RLC certified champion. We're launching officially the RKC. You guys are probably gonna say, what is RKC? RKC stands for Remy Line Kennel Club. That's our official registry, which accepts all bloodlines, all colors, all dogs, all sizes, whatever you want to throw in there, we put in there. UKC uses something called Purple Ribbon. Well, we use two different acronyms. We have RLC, which stands for Remy Line Certified. Those are dogs that met all of the standards and qualities to be a Remy Line Certified dog. If your dog is not a Remy Line dog, we use an acronym called CRC, which stands for Certified Remy Club. What that means is dogs like Gaudy Line, Razor's Edge, Gaff, if they meet all of the qualifications of Remy Line Standard, you can get certified by CRC. The good thing is our shows now, the RLC shows, is open up to all bloodlines. We've been doing these the last couple shows. It's doing really, really well. Over in New Jersey, big ups, because a Gaudy Line dog won first place. As you can see, it's growing and it's doing really, really well. One thing I want to explain of our judging, because a lot of people don't understand our judging. We are judged by a point system. The way that works is, we go for the total package dogs. We don't go by who the owner of the dog is. We don't go by the color of the dog. We go by the total package dog. Meaning, if your dog has a skinny head and a skinny neck and a skinny rear and a skinny shoulder and a skinny tail and it's a straight out skinny dog, that's 100% conformational dog, and that dog could be a champion. We get 5 points for head to neck, neck to shoulders, body to rear, personality, stacking. We added on two more. Coat of the dog and overall package of the dog. We don't just let the biggest head dog win. We don't let the most coolest owner of the dog win. We don't care what bloodline the dog is. That overall dog's gonna win. The points are there. You could ask to see your points. Your points will be justified based on what we see based on the dogs. So keep coming to the shows. We got some big ones coming up. One in December, one in November, January, February. In fact, every month we got a show coming up. RKC, check out the Remy Line Certified shows. It's the place to be. Peace.
Hey, this Bugs, Inglewood Bully Kennel. Meet my one-year-old boy, Mr. Bully the Kid. He's a grandson of Mac-10 and a grandson of Easy Rider. He's 75% Razor Edge, 25% Gaudy Line. Got a lot of drive, got a lot of bone, and he got head, and he's short to the ground. Bully to the bone. So hit me up, 310-462-8066. 310-462-8066. Inglewood Bullies.
How you doing? My name is Roger, and I'm the owner of the Inland Dog Parlor, mobile dog washing and grooming service. I do all breeds. Right now I'm specializing in the bully breeds. You know, a lot of dog parlors, grooming places don't even want to accept the breed. You know, and I know and you know, the bullies are the most docile breeds of them all, man. They're my best customers. Speaking of customers, you know, some of the customers under my books now, I got Oscar from Blue Pride. I do, you know, the legend himself. I do Easy Rider, his son Lolo, Tommy Gunn, all those guys out there, you know. I do regular maintenance, or I prepare dogs for the dog show. You know, I do Zen style also. You know, right before the Nationals, I was out there with Sylvia doing Pokemon for the National. That's why, you know, you saw them all nice and shiny out there. You know, we de-whiskered him, took down his nails real nice and low, so, you know, he was picture perfect out there, man. Full grooming services, just like taking your dog to the groomers, your local groomers, only I come to you. You know, a lot of people like to sit and watch, and see the whole, you know, you're more than welcome to do that. What I do is I put them in the tub. You know, that's where we give them the spray wash there, soak them down. Depending on the color of the dog, you know, the shampoo, if it's a white one, I got nice, you know, just shampoo specifically for white dogs. We shampoo them there, rinse them off, let that soak in, rinse them off. And then what I'll do is brush the teeth right in there. I'm sorry, one thing I did forget during the wash, and a lot of people don't mention, is that I do anal expression. A lot of people don't know what that is. You know, that's just domestic dogs have now, most of them have lost the ability to extract this anal juice that, you know, similar to, just to give you an example, it's what skunks shoot out in a defense mechanism. So if you don't do that every so often, you can, it actually causes infection. So I do that during the wash. Once that's done, we swing them over to the grooming table and do any type of trimming around the genitals, whiskers if you wanted to. That's where we do the toenails. Either file them down or clip them down, you know, whatever it requires. You know, do the ear solution in there to loosen up any type of debris or dirt. And then I do a thorough cleaning inside. The ear portion of it is another sometimes forgotten area of the dog that people you know, tend to put aside. A lot of infections can happen, a lot of ear mites, if that's not periodically cleaned correctly. So we do all that, everything, that whole service. Then a nice scent at the end, you know, of your choice. And, you know, that's all included in the regular package there. The unit itself, I have it air conditioned. So in the summer afternoons, it's nice and cool for the dog. In the winter, I got the water heated. So no stress on the dog. Full freshwater wash. We blow dry the dog if you want it, or towel dry. In the summer, towel is more than sufficient. I have really good introductory prices, especially for kennels. I do real good discounts for the kennels. Basically, for one dog, when I go out to your home, it's $25 for the full service that I just mentioned. Your second and third dog will be $20. And listen to this, any dog after the third dog, it's only $15. And that's why I say, you know, the way you save is the more dogs you have, the better pricing that gets you. And that's my kennel discount that I mentioned.
Say, man, what y'all doing over here, man?
Man, what the hell you mean what y'all doing over here?
Hey, man, get y'all ass off my field, man. Hey, hold on, man. Don't walk up to me, man. Stay back. Hey, hold on, man. Hold on, man. Don't walk up on me, man. Hey, man, back up, man. Back up, partner. Hold on. Watch. Hey. Watch. Yay. Hi-ya, hi-ya. Watch it, boy. Hi-ya, 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 hi-ya. Good boy. Chopper. Oh. Yay. Hi-ya. Yay. Good boy. Freeze. Here. Hey, how you doing? I'm Jeff from Master K9, Los Angeles, California. This is my man Malcolm, head trainer, Master K9. Down here we do a lot of training, basic obedience, advanced obedience, personal protection.
What we mainly do here is customize the dog for you. My lifestyle and your lifestyle is different. You have to tell us what some of your fears are or what you need the dog to do. We test the dog, and then if the dog has it in, we customize the dog for you.
Up. Good boy. Squat. Good boy.
We have an excellent obedience course. Anything from beginning obedience to advanced obedience. We take personal time to teach you the correct way to handle the dog. In our obedience courses, the dogs are very well socialized. There'll be no aggression. We tolerate no aggression on our field towards another animal.
Good boy. Heel. Focus. Good boy. Heel. Good boy. Focus. Good boy. Squat. Good boy. And everything is praised with the dog.
During our obedience course, we can teach your dog to stand, to take certain poses. When you give him a command, you won't have to tell him 3-4 times to do this certain command. We'll guarantee one time the dog will obey.
We have your dog ready for the show to where he's not aggressive towards other dogs. Sit at your command when you don't have to tell him more than once. The judges look for this at these shows. They make sure that your dog has good posture. And like I said again, which is very important, that the dog is not dog aggressive, because they're very close to other dogs. It can be dog aggressive. The judges look for that. These bullies are very good breed of dogs. A lot of people just keep them tied up in their backyard, keep them locked up in cages, but they're working dogs. We encourage you guys, bring them dogs down to Master K9. We have a facility here, as you will see, where we have obstacle courses. Bring them, let them run obstacles, let the dog be the dog.
Usually a pit, even your fighting pits, are not aggressive toward people. You know, kids can go right up to them and play with them. They're only aggressive against another animal. If you raise a pit right, he's just like any other dog. My daughter was raised with a pit that slept up under her bed. Never had any problems. This dog, you know, my daughter pulled this dog's ears, bit the dog's tail. The dog never was aggressive against her. I train pits every day. I'm not prejudiced against a pit. A pit took my end of my finger off, and still I train them every day. You know, I didn't blame the pit for this. This was my fault. You know, you can't blame the animal, you blame the owner. It's what man makes him.
Yeah, once again, thanks for coming visiting us down here at LA's Master K9. If you have any questions, you can contact me, Jeff, 323-822-6028. You can contact Malcolm, which is the head trainer, at area code 323-392-9577. Or you can look us up on the website, lasmasterk9.com.